All right, here's a video I wanted to make about a situation I've run into with these 18650 batteries that I found odd when I first ran into it, and it makes sense now, but I haven't seen anything about it really on YouTube, and I've watched a bunch of videos about pulling apart laptop packs from various YouTubers, and I have never seen it mentioned, and it only showed up to me after I started searching for this. So, what I ran into was in these fairly new laptop packs, fairly new, about 4 years old or so, I'd find these cells that were reading 0 volts and open circuit, just no resistance. Or infinite resistance, and you know this meter does work. So I ran into a bunch of these, and in some packs I'd run into 3 or 4 of them, and these were only a few years old, so it didn't make sense. I'd expect it out of a 10-year-old pack, but out of a 4-year-old pack that was taken out of service like a year ago, it just didn't make sense to me. So, what I ended up doing was I ended up cutting a cell apart, because I figured it was dead, there's no danger in taking it apart. And once I started cutting into the top, I got partway down, I actually got into where the rolled up cell material is, which you can see here, and I found that, let me correct the focus here. And I found that there was, it actually passed a lot of current, so then I knew the cell wasn't dead. So I will check the voltage here. And this shows showing 4.1 volts. So what I ended up finding was underneath the top of the cell, the button top here, there is a little kind of disc, and when this pops out due to high pressure within the cell, it cuts the current off. The papers I've seen on it call it a CID, or a current interrupt device. So when pressure builds up within the cell, it pops that disc out and it disconnects the cell from circuit. So, I'll just give a little example here. I just cut the top off of this to show for the video because it's a junk cell, but this cell, is reading 0 volts. But what I'll do is, I'll use something not as sharp. I'll poke that button in. I can't see in video here. I'll just watch and look at myself. So I'll poke that in. See, you saw that go pop. Now, 2.26 volts. So this is what the cell should normally look like, but something happened to this thing, and it popped that little protection disc. So what I've done is to show it. I've pulled a cell apart. So this is the whole assembly as it sits on top of the cell. Let me focus this and get it a little more manageable. So we've got the rolled up material inside the cell, and the positive top is separated from the negative outer shell with this plastic insulator here. And then we've got the positive electrode coming up on this small foil here. That connects to the bottom of this little disc, which I can pop off. So here's the top button top. And here is that disc I was pressing earlier. And underneath it. Underneath it is a small little metal disc. Let's fix this. You can see where that little rounded point makes connection with this guy here, and it's insulated in plastic. So when this pressure builds up and this is popped out, that breaks the circuit. You're not going to be able to see it here, but you know, that's essentially what happens. So once you press this back down, it completes the circuit again. So I found that odd, because I was just very surprised when I was running into those cells. And in experimenting, I found that with some of these, you know, it's not going to be the smartest thing, some will say, but, you know, you can use your own brain, do what you want to do. I got a Samsung cell here, another one of those I was finding 0 volts, and there's no messing around here. I mean, I'm not trying to fool you, nothing. And I found that if you get a small enough screwdriver, you can pop it underneath here, give it a little pry, pop it underneath, pry, and give it a gentle little pry, then you can reconnect that without butchering the top of the cell. Interesting little find. I mean, I guess what happens is for that thing to pop, these things must get pretty hot. And I work with computers, and I found that the computers these machines come out of, I've personally witnessed one where I grabbed the back of the machine and the pack was so hot I could not hold on to it for more than a couple seconds. It was up near 160 degrees. So I'm figuring these machines or these packs must have an issue with overcharging, and that's why I'd find so many all in one fairly new pack that were registering 0 volts, open circuit. It just confused me quite a bit that they were new cells, so I just threw them all aside, figuring they were bad. But then, out of curiosity, found that you could just actually reset them. Now, I haven't tested any of these yet. Some might be decent, but a lot of these were real crappy, real crappy. Like 400 to 700 milliamps, and I mean, it's usable, but out of a 2,000, 2,500 milliamp cell, that's kind of crappy, and especially only being a few years old. But these had a hard life. So just to mess around a little more here, I can. This is another one that should be 0 volts. Yep. What I'll do for you is cut the top off. And you can see that same button there. Has popped up. So what I'll do, I haven't done this yet, but what I'll do is I will press it down with my multimeter, and you can watch. So we have 0 volts. There it goes. I'm gonna press it a little harder there. Oh, that actually had pressure built up in it. But there we go, 4.1. Because the first thing I was doing was I thought this was a automatically resetting device. So I'd try popping a hole in the bottom and relieving the pressure, and it wasn't resetting this. So then I found cutting the top off that you could just, you know, without dicking around with it too much, just, you know, you got nothing here, and then just pop it back down. Now, this is obviously not the safest thing, but hell, just for a little lesson, found it interesting. All right, thank you.